relaxing, listening to Boy George. What's up with that? My wife has that on. Yeah, leaving for the Transatlantic Europe tour today. Wahoo. I'm still hoping it won't happen.
And he's not really laying around on the couch.
Right, no. Yeah, with an illusion, right?
This was all for...
That was for the effect.
It's like home.
So you can feel sorry for me when I'm out on tour in the bus. It's not right. Like anybody's ever going to feel sorry for me ever. For anything. Okay, bye.
All right, we're going to have some fun now.
In England. Look at this place. Hello. Yeah, this is like we're out in the middle of this, of the English countryside here.
I'll see you in about an hour.
There's Pete.
And if you pay for it all, I'll pay you back.
What a guy.
Thank you.
He'll even pay you back.
See you soon, Stuart. Bye bye.
In full view of the nuclear power plants. Yes. Hello.
And the sheep.
The sheep. Where are the sheep?
They're the other side.
Oh. Other side. Oh, yeah, I guess I kind of noticed them through my jet-lagged haze.
That's the horrible bit.
What's that?
That's
I like the... Yeah, the nasty, the pools of old poison gas situation here.
Oh, we're going to bury that one day.
Was that funny? Did that get funny, or was it just me?
It was
pretty funny.
And where was that?
Hey, we're actually here in one room. Hi, Rona. How's it going? This is for the next, what is that? Oh. Oh, I thought you were recording me. So this is the funny farm. The fruit farm.
I think you were right the first time.
Yeah.
Oh, this is good.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
It's funky. It's funky.
Pretty cool environment. It's all right. You know, beneath the shade of the nuclear power plants. That's a...
It's not nuclear.
Hey, you guys, I figure I better shoot a lot of footage. So, you know, we haven't put out any product for about a week, I think. So we need to have the rehearsals for the tour. You know, have it be its own.
This will be the bonus third CD on the forthcoming live box set.
Right.
The only band to have a live box set with only two studio albums. Wait, I wonder if there's been a band that's had more live albums than studio albums. Maybe the Stones, probably.
I don't know.
Well, we need him there.
Okay.
Hello. It's the next day. And, at the Astoria in London, I've been practicing with my little dressing room here. Hello. It's funny watching in there. I'm gonna go down and see what the guys are doing. They left my keyboards in Oxford. And, so somebody's driving my keyboards in. But, oh yeah, the guys are practicing now. I've been just practicing on the baby keyboard. Yeah, I don't know if my,
keyboard's on here.
Oh, the keyboards are here. Oh, excellent. I was just saying, I don't know if I have any keyboards yet. This is the labyrinth of stairs that exists behind the Astoria that I've gotten lost in many times. You know, I've never played anywhere but here in London, like the small venue or the big one. Let's see. They have to put up all these signs because it's just insane. One time I asked a guy how to get to the showers, like from the other venue, and he gave me the most hilarious directions. Oh, stage. Okay.
Have you sorted out what you're going to do about that the octave down heavy part?
Yes.
Cool.
The pedals are way too low.
Have you used?
Can we get bass pedals down?
It's the Astoria with nobody in it. Well, that's probably enough of that. Oh, here's where I'm going to be.
Like a hair.
No keyboards, you'll notice.
As we say.
Daniel, hello.
I have one.
Yeah, he has his keyboard, right?
Okay.
No, that's all right.
This is Club
Club Transatlantic.
Hey! Is it never enough?
Welcome to Club Transatlantic.
Yeah, right.
Hey, this is kind of like Chris's room. We like to think of Chris when we... Oh,
yeah, Chris? You know, Chris's room is covered Chris with Squire, hash smoke. We have potato chips and...
Can I just say, usually when the band is in the dressing room... come on,
Mike. Give me Derek. I haven't got on the film yet.
Usually, a monitor guy will position himself at the monitor board during a sound check of the name.
Yeah, the neck thing is crucial.
Has anybody ever told you that you resemble Guy Smiley?
Guy Smiley?
John Petrucci. John always is telling me that.
You remind him of Guy Smiley.
And I'm like, I don't know who that is. It's a guy
on... You don't know Guy Smiley?
He's the guy on Sesame Street or something? Yeah. I don't know. Hey, Jerry.
What, the blue one?
Could you film the first bit of this set? Could you?
He's like the game show host. He's always hosting the game shows.
That'd be great.
Guy Smiley. Is
that a little bit? I'm trying not to be insulted that I'm the game show host, okay? All right. It's okay.
Guy Smiley.
Hey.
Minutes for five. We have a couple minutes.
Oh, we have a couple minutes. We do.
Well, go have fun starting the show.
See you in half an hour.
A high five would be okay.
I love you guys. Come on.
I know that you're starting the show by yourself.
Okay, guys.
We are
in time, right?
Thank you.
You wish you could stop dreaming in clouds of white. Well, everything could change tonight.
Hello.
When you're dealing with the devil living in your mind, time reveals nothing. It's a suicide love affair. Whispers in the darkness and revolution.
Every time.
myself to clap along and wish you well. Motherless children wandering nowhere, look up, you're almost home. Reaching for water, longing to know you're not alone. You're not alone.
Oh. in Belgium now. We saw Yes last night. Hung out with.
We went to the camp. Squire. What was it? Camp Yes or Yes?
Yeah, yo, Club Yes.
Club Yes.
Club Yes. Yeah.
It was like being in Amsterdam. By the way, I expect director's credit now. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Or at least cinematographer.
Do you want to just say that's a wrap now? Or? I wrote something this morning that might wind up on the new Spox. I don't know if it will or not, but I kind of woke up with this idea. And that bit that I used as a bridge in Open Wide the Floodgates, that you spent your life running away thing. I just kept thinking about that this morning. And I don't think this is what I was thinking, but this is what I came up with anyway. Actually, I had this conversation with my brother Richard yesterday in Frankfurt, and we were talking about spiritual things, and he was talking about, you know, wanting to get to the place where there's no separation between, you know, there's no separation between you and God, and there's no place where that ends and you start or whatever. And I thought that was really cool. So I wrote this thing called No Separation. You spent your life on, let's see, I think I changed it now. I've spent my life running away. Stuck with my feet in the miry clay. As well as this morning. But there came a time when I had a revelation that I am you and you are me, and there is no separation. Yes, I am you and you are me, and there is no separation.
Time seeing John Anderson last night.
You just bring that?
Yeah, this morning.
Oh, cool.
You've been like a runaway train. And in your wake, lives have been hurt and left in pain. But there'll be a time when you roll into the station.
Quickly, guys.
Yes.
There's a big metal fire curtain that, if it falls down, will
crush anything that goes underneath it. So they're saying...
A metal fire curtain? Yeah. Like the iron curtain? Are we behind the iron curtain?
So we have to set up further back than the front of the stage.
Oh, okay.
Is what they're saying.
So I can't do my edge of the stage thing. That's all right.
Oh, thank you!
But the monitor line has had to be moved back. They're saying,
okay.
And they're saying it has to be there because of this fire.
That's all right.
No. My answer is no.
Yeah? Okay. Well, they're saying...
I like to be as close to the audience.
What's bizarre about it is that they're saying we can set up further forward if we take everything off the risers, but they don't want their risers destroyed in case the fire comes.
No.
They don't mind if...
I believe I said...
What do they mean in case the fire comes down? Does it just come down right
now? Yeah, no, I mean if there's a fire, then it will come down. It will shut the stage off from the audience.
And they don't want
how interesting.
Have you never had that before?
No, I never really.
Yeah. It's a big hunk of iron.
I was having an autistic moment.
Autistic?
I like that. I like that, Neil.
Do you? I was going to have somebody tape the gig in Paris, but... I forgot to. Anyway, now I'm in Tilburg, Holland. Look at this view from my room in Tilburg. Pretty cool, huh? Here's the town square. It's nice. Nice cathedral. And then we're playing the ever-popular 013, and they're shooting a DVD tonight, so should be pretty good. Okay. See ya. All right, this proves it. We're actually playing here. There it is. Transatlantic Montage. Isn't that cool? And this is here in Holland where people do all kinds of crazy stuff. On the way to the gig. See ya.
Mr. Barber.
Hey, you can't record.
Hello.
You filmed it! I can't believe you filmed that.
No, I just turned it on just now. Why? What were you saying, Pete? What were you saying, Pete?
I wasn't. Thomas, was that again? Thomas,
that sounds like you're on a school trip or something. You're having so much fun. And out
with each other. You said something about a party in Milan.
Milan?
Yeah, I gotta say that. I've been enjoying the hotels and stuff.
I thought you were gonna come.
I've been enjoying everything that's not happening at the shows. It's been great.
See, I'm finding the opposite. The only thing I'm enjoying is the shows. The two and a half hours on stage is glorious.
You know what I'm enjoying?
21 and a half hours.
I'm enjoying the shows too. I didn't enjoy Paris so much. I don't know why.
I'm enjoying the rehearsals as well because in Marillion. We sound check and then we
rehearsals.
Yeah, it's killing.
You're enjoying rehearsals.
I'm enjoying the
I thought
the rehearsals before, all the playing on stage during the sound checks. I love all that because in Marillion we don't. It's like everyone's like, no, I'm not going to play for any longer than we have to.
Right, yeah.
And they all do that, and they all just scarp, and it's like, we never arrange anything that could be fun in the music.
Well, we would be like that probably if we, maybe in a week. If we did a week from now.
Exactly, if we didn't need to rehearse.
Yeah, then we'd just be like, okay, got it. Yeah, done. Back to the hotel, you know.
Pete's getting a rock star.
Said the best time for the cassette change would be after Sweet Charlotte
Park. After Charlotte and before Stranger. So
I'll have a little break there.
Give a minute before you even say anything. You know?
Yeah, I think space is good in a set like this with
so many
long pieces. You know.
Okay.
So it's there's six songs in total. It's after between the fourth and the fifth song.
Okay.
Six including the encore.
That's only the encore.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Oh, by the way,
tell them to move.
May I make
quick.
A suggestion?
No.
I suggest that we do not. For the encore, that we do not have the intro.
Oh, yeah,
I think it'd be cooler to count it in and just, yeah, you know, and just kind of surprise them more.
I love the spaceship taking off.
Do you? I don't.
Of did you think I was going to say, good idea? Yeah. What were the chances of that?
Yeah,
ever?
But I think they're going to have to hear that like every time they run the DVD, you know?
I don't care. I don't feel strongly about it. I just think it'd be stronger to just, you know, people would not know what we were going to play, and then you'd count in, and then we'd hit it, and they'd all go mad.
Yeah, me too. I think as it's the encore, okay. And it's the release of the show, it's like everyone can, you know, stop having to listen to the notes and stuff.
Why should we go mad?
They like that song. Can you call
I like that song.
that collection of songs and themes known as All of the Above. Oh yeah, that's a strong one. That's the one I enjoy the most. I think because the pressure's off. I think that for me, like it's like, okay, I know that because I know that one the best.
That's the one I enjoy the most because that means we're only 30 minutes away from the pizza.
Ending. From what?
From the pizza.
All right. Well, you know, there's a lot of pressure for me on the other ones. You know, like, I hope I don't make some like glaring mistakes.
It does feel very comfortable, that one. Like,
that one, yeah.
Playing it, it's like, especially because I play that at clinics, so I'm constantly playing that one.
Yeah, it's just
so I like that song is now at least the first half, which I do at the clinics, is like I don't have to think of it at all.
Yeah.
Where the other ones, I'm still thinking, you know.
Oh, I'm thinking a lot. I'm probably thinking too much. It'd probably be better if I relaxed. You know, it's like there's so much stuff to remember, man. You know, with all the lyrics and the vocal cues and the patch changes and both keyboard parts. And
you really don't want the intro, huh?
You know what I'd like to do if we ever did this again? If we ever did this again. Well, I'd like to really have a hidden other keyboard player.
A sixth.
Hey, we know the guy.
You know what we really need?
Yeah. Like, Rio would not. Who?
You know what I think we should.
He knows how to do that. Right?
I think we should.
Never mind the man behind the curtain.
I think we should.
He can be out of the stage.
You know. Mike's not really covering it very
well. Yeah, Mike's not really acting. Let's get another drummer too.
We'll be right back.
Experience, went running and found this thing that looked like a big fortress. It turned out to be like a Catholic cemetery, like a huge one where they have these huge like marble houses with a family name on it, I guess, where they bury all the people from the family. I mean, and just miles and miles of it. Really amazing. And then I was walking back and I passed by a school and the kids were all playing and laughing, and I had this song idea.
Differences, but the children are the same. The children are the same everywhere. We may feel our emptiness, but the children feel no pain. They're laughing in the rain everywhere.
Where do the children play? I just want to lay that down. I gotta exercise and get ready for sound check.
We're playing in a circus tent.
Yes, for the first time in my life, I'm playing in a circus tent.
It's somehow appropriate for Transatlantic, isn't it?
And
hello.
Hi.
We just interview you now.
Right. Okay. So, where did you get your start?
Wait a minute. Hello.
This is for Rock TV, right?
Yeah, you have to say hello.
Hi.
Hola.
Hey, I'll zoom in right now. Get right out there with all the people out in TV land. Okay.
Cos'è che vorresti che dicessi ciao Rock TV? Or?
No, se vogliono fare dei saluti per Rock TV, sì.
Yeah,
just a nice regular lighting.
A voi che dice io sono Mike Portnoy, yeah, allora
sì, sì.
Oh, yeah. And say whatever you want to
do. Solo loro, sì, sì, solo loro due vicini.
Ok, sorry.
Just looking in the camera, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, oh.
You want me and Neil to do one together or one each separate?
Tutto, oh.
We'll do one each and then one together.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, only audio? No, TV.
Okay.
I'll do one first.
I'm half okay. Japanese, but I'm not good at it. Oh. It's not very on focus. Is it okay?
Mosaico.
Oh, well. Oh, it's on. It got switched to something. Go ahead. Do your thing, Mike.
Okay. You ready? And we're watching Rock TV. Ciao.
You ready? No?
Okay, può andare?
Hi, this is Neil Morse from Spock's Beard and Transatlantic, and you're watching Rock TV. Rock, dude. Together?
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Buongiorno.
Hey, this is Mike and Neil from Transatlantic and other things.
Other things as well, but we're here together right now.
Okay.
He's giving us the start right now.
Oh.
Buongiorno!
Hey,
this is Mike Portnoy.
And Neil Morse from Transatlantic.
And we're hanging right here on Rock TV. Ciao, baby!
Hey, thank you so much.
Our pleasure.
Sì, grazie. Senti, gli chiedi se gli va di farlo questo.
You're not gonna make the face? Yeah, we had done something. Start looking behind. Hey, you know, we might want to encourage Roina to get a cheat sheet for his lyrics to, Hey, Mike?
Yes, sir.
You want to encourage Roina or, you know, to do a cheat sheet for the lyrics to Shine On, maybe? It's not on. No, I'm lying. It is. I have a lot of footage of you doing that, by the way. Hey.
That's what he does.
Mike's
hey,
doing his thing.
Hey.
Whatever you want
you to do. You got a lot of footage of this?
Once I've done that one. Don't ever
he's expected.
Oh.
What if you really don't know anything? This is great. It's almost the end of the tour. It's like, what are those words again?
I'm kind of singing along.
Whatever you want to change, you better start changing your mind.
You can encourage Roy to do a cheat sheet. Why do I have to do that?
Oh, I don't know. He likes you better.
I'm not sure about that.
Well, and oh no, I know why. Because you actually know the words, and I don't. You know the words. Hello.
To which song?
To Shine On.
I don't anticipate doing that tonight, though.
Well, I bet we probably will, because it's Karlsruhe. These people, they rock.
Karlsruhe.
Yeah, you never played here before?
This place has nothing about, you know, so they live for their music.
I just, every gig I've ever done here has been pretty, pretty good. And
you've done more than one gig in Karlsruhe.
I've played here three times. Played here with Eric once and twice with Spock.
I did a drum clinic here, but I have absolutely no recollection.
Because everything can be done. Stand up, because this is your time.
Who's the heavy metal singer that would do that? Time. A little bit of that.
Time.
A little bit of Axl Rose.
Time.
Something like that.
I can't remember Axl.
Give me more Never Is Enough, man.
More Never Is Enough.
She sat by the river, reading a book, feeding her dreams. Now she's a loner, now she's a stoner, no one can touch her. He was a boy, pride of his mother, his name isn't shining, all heaven sent. But then the country calls for a soldier, and he went off.
I knew the world.
Wait, you're not on yet. Tell us about this web Pete.
Well,
so what's up with this? It's a bloody disaster.
No, we're going to paint the electrical items blue, but the leads are going to stay grey with the walls. And this lead hasn't been painted yet, but they're going to do that tomorrow. Okay. Hello, Berlin! And
Mike's in his full Berlin
one.
Regalia.
Oh, Mike, no, you've left your line, man. What's this?
You know, I slept this off, actually. Ah, man, I was in some mood earlier, man.
Yeah, he was in some mood earlier.
It was
earlier.
A Berlin thing, man.
Berlin, oh, wait.
With you in Berlin,
yeah, well,
man.
You got that,
it makes me absolutely cuckoo.
Yeah, he was a little on the cuckoo side.
I must show you something.
Oh, Pete's excited.
Yeah, look, I wanted a little...
We go on in... What's that say? 9:06.
We've been on for 6 minutes now.
I can't count. Yeah, we go on another 6 minutes, or?
No, we were on 6 minutes.
4 minutes,
ago.
4 minutes.
So, yeah, I wanted a memento of the tour.
Yeah.
Memento? And,
he wanted a placebo.
So, I bought myself an Epiphone guitar.
Yeah, check it out. Well, come into the light, man. Can't see you. Ah. Sing us a song, Pete.
Oh, boy.
La, 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 la.
I could do...
Did you figure that out in high school or something?
I figured it out just after the Yes concert.
You really? Did
yes,
you really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. It's nice, man.
It's lovely. It's lovely. And it's black, you know, the best color.
Yes.
For guitars.
Black is the color of my true love's hair.
Yeah, it's lovely. And the Epiphone, for some reason.
I don't actually mean that. It's a song. My wife's hair is black. What are you talking about?
Oh, I wasn't listening to you. I was still talking myself. Yeah, so, anyway. There you have it.
You're really English, huh, Pete? You're not just putting it on, right?
I'm really English. No, actually,
hey, there's Dirk.
Another 10 minutes later.
Really? Oh, no. Dirk, labor,
really?
Dirk.
We'll work on it.
I'm actually from South Carolina. But,
so we're going at 9:20 then?
Yes.
Okay.
It's so uncool to be from South Carolina that I put this English accent on.
Oh, okay.
That's totally
it's in the saddest of all keys.
Oh, man, it's freezing in here.
Yeah,
all
it really is. It's cold everywhere.
I can feel the temperature of this room. They haven't discovered many things here, such as water, electricity, food.
All of Neil's relatives, right?
Oh, it's happening. My goodness. That was Daniel. You all right, Daniel?
That
door is annoying, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's up with,
yeah.
What's up with this?
Yeah,
what's up
yeah.
with this painting with the thing through that lady's neck, man? That's not very cool. I thought it was out of your system, Mike. Uh-oh, he's back! He's back! We better call the paramedics. He's been doing this all day. You okay, man? Yeah, the Yoko thing. That was like a really fun sound check. Can you do that like full on into everybody's microphone like every day? He's losing it, man. Mike, it's only 4 more days, man.
I don't think it has anything to do with the length. And it just has completely 100% to do with the absolute backwardness of this city.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean East Berlin? I mean, regular Berlin's not so backward.
Well, are we in regular Berlin? I don't think so.
Well,
hey, give me the Derek the virtuoso thing. Come on. Come on.
I'm not like you have.
I'll have to catch you later.
You can't ask for it. It has to just come.
It has to be natural. This is what I got the camera out for in the first place. I think this is great. Hello, pizza. Mike's playing his invisible pads. What was that you said, Daniel?
So your camera's on. It doesn't.
Right. It said invisible, that means you like can't see it, right? What was that 2112 thing? So they did this album called 2112. And the idea is that you have to rush.
That's the message, yeah. Right. You must rush because...
Yeah, you have to like rush.
Like stops, like 2112. Now everything could just like end.
So you have to rush to get there to that time? Is that the concept?
Kind of. Well, blimey. Yeah.
Just kill us and get it over.
Well, second time around, it was really good.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah, it was even funnier the second time around.
Dirk Leiberger.
Hey, man.
Another ten minutes, is it?
Yeah, we're going on.
Half hour left?
5 minutes.
Why? Is it bad?
Still people outside.
Well, of course
there is. Trying to get in.
Well, open the fucking doors and let him in.
There he is. It's the thing!
That's what they do. Dr. Tricky says it's like Tourette's syndrome.
Oh, is that
what
it is?
There's
a guy! My brother Richard has a song about somebody who has Tourette's syndrome that can't help but just blurting out cuss words. Because it goes over really well in pubs because everybody just wants to like scream out cuss words as much as they can.
Tourette's yeah. Boy. It's called Tourette's Boy.
Color Clash tonight.
Oh, what happened to the Jetsons t-shirt?
Wow.
Meet George Jetson.
Jane, his wife.
His wife, Jane.
His boy, Elroy. What was the daughter's name? Daughter Judy?
The dog?
Yeah, what's up with the dog?
Elroy, right?
No, that was the boy. His boy, Elroy. I really know when to shoot, and when the good things really happen.
Yeah, since it gets exciting. Yeah.
Right, I just know. It's the thing. Berlin head. Come on, I haven't gotten the Derek thing yet. If you feel inspired.
Mm-hmm. I've gotten clothes anyway. Derek sent all some stuff to me.
Derek sent that stuff?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, wow. Cool.
Is that true?
Do you have a scarf and everything now?
No.
Does he take off his scarf and have his tech?
No, he didn't wear a scarf. He used to wear a feathered boa.
Really?
One of those big feathered boas?
Right.
I swear to God.
The full-on thing.
He had a yellow... His nickname was Nicky Lemons. That was his alter ego.
Really?
Nicky Lemons. And he would wear these big Bono glasses with the yellow tint.
Right.
And then the yellow boa. And then we would have this thing every once in a while ago, and I felt like Tourette's boy, actually. I would grab the mic and say, "You want the best. You got the best. The hottest band in the world. Nicky Lemons and the Migraines." And that was the cue. Everybody had to get ready. And then that was Derek's cue. He'd go out front. He'd get the feather boa on. And his Nicky Lemons was kind of like David Lee Roth meets, like, Joey Ramone. With a bit of the singer from B-52s mixed in. And then we had this song called "I Don't Like You." And then, like, I was the drummer. I was Mikey Migraine. And John was Johnny Migraine. And then at that point, John Mayong and James just walked up the stage, like, all pissed off at us. And we would play this punk song. It sounded like Green Day or the Ramones. And it was, and like, every once in a while when it was in a really dumpy place like this, in fact, that... We did it in Leipzig, East Germany.
Leipzig.
Too far from here.
Right.
Whenever yeah. It was just a night that I just could not take seriously, I'd grab the mic and introduce Nicky Lemons and the Migraines, and then the fun
Ladies
began.
And gentlemen!
We played it like 10 times, right? Across the world.
Virtuoso.
And it would confuse the hell out of people. Because they had no idea what we were up to.
Mikey.
Like, poor East Germans, they have all this crap around them, so everybody turns into crap when they come here as well. It's like...
How are you, Mikey?
Fine. I'm here to wire you up.
You gonna wire me up? You gonna hook me up? You gonna pump me up?
Plug you in.
It's not really time yet, is it?
Well, actually, it's like...
Oh, we're gonna go on 4 minutes? Okay.
you're looking for. Don't ever start looking behind. Whatever you want to change, you better start changing your mind. 'Cause everything can be done. Stand up, 'cause this is your time. Awakening the stranger in your soul.
night. And I'll be joining you there.
Come on, you believe, you hear a vision. Thank you.
Thank you, man.
Thank you. See you again soon, hopefully.
Thank you. Shine on. Merry Christmas.
Definitely.
Now, for God's sake, go home. Thank you. That really is all we know. Thank you very much, Berlin. Thank you. Try singing the guitar solos before we give it to Wayne?
No, man.
Come on, man, please.
That's going to bum out the whole gig.
How about Walk on the Wild Side by Lou Reed?
Hey, babe. Do whatever you want. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Portnoy. I think in our version, I think she makes an appearance.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you Yoko Ono. Gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, the one, the only, the incredible, the Earth's unsurmountable, the virtuoso, all the way from England, Mr. Pichuavis on bass. Thank you.
to wait. I have to take a piss. It's in that cup. How about the shizer?
Thank you.